stocking stuffers from Mr. Trudeau, while a cabinet minister gets a lump of coal. This is Now You Know. I'm Rob Snow.
All the news you need to know.
This is Now You Know with Rob Snow on News Radio.
Looking for a boost in the polls and to get past the stalemate in the House of Commons, Justin Trudeau is playing Santa Claus. The Prime Minister and his Finance Minister, Chrystia Freeland, are in Toronto today. They just outlined what they promised to be a multi-billion dollar plan to lower the cost of living. It includes a GST holiday. Starting in the middle of December, Canadians won't pay GST on many essential items, like some grocery products, beer and wine, prepared hot meals, diapers, children's clothing and children's shoes, child car seats, some toys, even Christmas trees. And that's not all. There's money on the way. Cold, hard cash. It's a plan that also includes sending a $250 check to every Canadian with an income of less than $150,000. The Prime Minister said this latest announcement is part of a suite of measures aimed to make life more affordable for Canadians struggling to get by.
The programs that we're delivering, whether it's dental care, whether it's pharmacare with free insulin or free prescription contraceptives, whether it's more spaces and $10 a day child care that is saving families thousands of dollars, whether it's dental care that's taken huge pressures off of primarily seniors' budgets, but also others. These are things that are making a difference. But at the same time, Canadians are still struggling to get by. These elements have taken off pressures, but there is more to do. As the holidays approach, families, especially parents, are particularly worried. Canadians have been through a lot. They work hard. We see that. We've been able to get through the past couple of years. Everyone had to tighten their belts a little bit. And now we're going to be able to give a tax break for all Canadians.
If this all sounds somewhat familiar, that may be because the NDP pitched a very similar proposal just about a week ago.
We already made a decision in a lot of areas that are essentials that we don't apply GST. So right now, when you buy groceries, there's not GST applied to that. So that happens right at the till. And so we want to expand that to acknowledge that Canadians are going through a tough time. Yeah. And our daily essentials shouldn't be where government is nickel and diming people. And so we think about the things that you need. When you go to a grocery store and you buy some bread and sandwich meats, that's going to be no tax, no GST. But if you went to the deli at the same grocery store and grabbed a quick snack, a healthy snack there, that would have tax. We want to take it off of that. Okay. When we look at some of the essentials, we all need access to the internet. So cell phone and internet now is a crucial, vital thing that we need in our lives. We want to take the GST off of that as well. When we look at some of the needs for kids, when we're buying children's clothing or diapers, they still have GST applied to those. We'd remove it from those as well. So this could happen at the point of sale, and it would be removed immediately. No application, no rebate, just a direct removal. Acknowledging that these things are essentials, let's give people a break right now.
Now, this new Liberal plan doesn't go as far as that NDP plan did. The NDP, as you just heard, offered to take the GST off of home heating bills, internet subscriptions, cell phone bills, and the NDP said it would make the savings permanent. But by all accounts, the NDP will support these measures. There are reports the two sides have actually been talking about it in recent days. The Liberal plan would come into effect December 14th and last until February 15th. Mr. Singh is expected to speak in a couple of hours just before going into the House of Commons for question period. So does this mean the old band is back together? It would seem so. It was just in September that the NDP ended its formal agreement with the Liberals. Since then, the party said it would give its support to Liberal legislation on a case-by-case basis. And in this case, it sounds like it's a go. The Liberals are desperately trying to boost their standing in the polls, with affordability being a top issue for Canadians. There's a new poll out today from Abacus Data. That poll gives the Conservatives a 22-point lead over the Liberals. The Conservatives at 43% support nationally. The Liberals and the NDP tied at 21% each. In addition to that, Abacus says the Conservatives hold commanding leads in every part of the country except Quebec, where the Bloc Québécois is leading with 36% support. Outside of Quebec, the NDP has actually pulled ahead of the Liberals by a couple of points. Abacus notes the Conservatives lead among all age groups and genders, with the largest gap among older voters. While Mr. Trudeau plays Santa Claus, Randy Boissonneau, Trudeau's scandal-plagued jobs minister, is getting a lump of coal. After months of nonstop stories about his business dealings and his claims about Indigenous identity, Prime Minister's office issued a statement just prior to yesterday's question period saying Boissonneau is out of the cabinet. But that didn't end the questions from the opposition about why it took so long. This is Conservative MP Michael Barrett, a member of the Ethics Committee and the Ethics Critic for the official opposition.
Randy Boissonneau has resigned. This is following Conservative calls for Randy Boissonneau's resignation after he lied about his status, claiming to be Indigenous, to win government contracts, that he said that he wasn't directing his business from the cabinet table, from Trudeau's government cabinet, when we know that he was, that he said that it was some other Randy who was named in all those text messages, but we know he is the only Randy, and of course that his business was sharing an address with drug smugglers, and we know now that his business and his former business partner by the Edmonton police.
But Boissonneau does still have his supporters, among them Nova Scotia Liberal MP Jamie Batiste, who has been the chair of the Liberal Party's Indigenous Caucus.
Mr. Boissonneau has never gone to Indigenous Caucus as an Indigenous person. I've said this many times. Since 2019, I've been chair of Indigenous Caucus. He has never approached me and said, I want to be part of Indigenous Caucus as anything but an ally. I've been clear with folks on that. And I'll continue. I spoke to Randy about that. And, I think that part of the discussion needs to be told, is he is not a sitting member of Indigenous Caucus as an Indigenous person.
Boissonneau had been under scrutiny for months. The House Ethics Committee has been digging into his former medical supply business and his business partner's texts and questions about the real Randy. On the issues of his Indigenous identity, Boissonneau's apologized for not being as clear as he could have been about his ancestry.
There is no question Rob won't get answered.
Now You Know with Rob Snow continues
on News Radio.
Well, he's our friend on the right side of things. Michael Tobe is with us at this time every week, syndicated columnist and speechwriter for former Prime Minister Stephen Harper. How are you today?
I'm good, Rob. How are you doing today?
Good. You must be feeling richer already with today's announcement, Michael.
I'm sure we all are. Oh, God. Yeah,
okay.
I know.
So you know how it works, so the listeners know what's going on. The Prime Minister just had his news conference just wrapped up in Toronto, affordability package that he's announcing. Any moment now, we expect to hear from Mr. Poilievre. So when he joins us and he starts speaking in English, we will take that live. You understand, of course, you know how it works in the live radio business. But look, this is, it's a big money deal here. All told, the GST exemptions and sending people $250 checks next year, it's going to be more than $6 billion. What do you make of it all?
I mean, the whole thing is so ludicrous. I posted it on X, the old Twitter. I'll just paraphrase it bluntly because I don't have it up. It says that if you're foolish enough to believe that a two-month moratorium on paying the GST for certain items, not all, but certain items, is enough to make up for years of economic neglect and ignorance and decline, then you're as foolish as the Liberal government that actually proposed it in the first place. This will do nothing. Sure, are people going to accept the fact that some of the items they're going to purchase for Christmas and the holidays and otherwise are not going to have GST on them? Yes, of course. Are they going to suddenly pay an additional amount of money that would replace the GST because even if the store doesn't offer to them? Of course not. They'll take advantage of it. But this does not prevent, and this does not stop, and this does not create or control the bleeding when it comes to economic hardship. That's what we've been dealing with, the affordability crisis. in this country. This moratorium isn't even a short-term solution. It's just something that, quite frankly, their old partners in the Supply and Confidence Agreement, the NDP, proposed, which was a winter GST holiday. They decided to implement it. The reasons are quite logical. They are dealing with Randy Boissonneau or Cocaine Randy or whatever you wish to call him being a problem on one end. And then you have all the changes that were made to immigration levels, a decline of 21% in total from an estimated total of about 500,000 going down to 395,000, which actually I covered in a column for the Daily Telegraph in the UK. That's what it is. It's just a distraction. This is not Justin Trudeau and his ministers coming to the reality that they now actually care about Canadians, that they're discouraged by what they see, that the affordability crisis that they allowed to happen shouldn't have happened in the first place, and that they're doing something about it. This isn't even patchwork. It's nothing. Canadians will take advantage of it, but it's absolutely nothing.
Okay, here are some of the items that are going to be exempt from the GST once this comes into effect. Again, it comes into effect on the 14th of December.
Right.
Children's clothing, footwear, diapers, car seats, selected toys for kids under 14 years of age, including puzzles and video games, print newspapers, printed books, natural and artificial Christmas trees. All right, no GST on the Christmas tree.
All right.
Food items, including chips, candies, baked goods, all prepared meals, catered meals, beverages, including pop, bottled water, beer and wine, and coolers with up to 7% alcohol content. So what do you expect the reaction to be from the leader of the official opposition? If you're Pierre Poilievre, what do you come out and say today?
He's just going to basically say he shouldn't say it's a patchwork solution to Canada's economic problems. He should just scoff at it because, yes, these are a lot of items that people will purchase for Christmas celebrations, Hanukkah, Kwanzaa for those who celebrate, et cetera, for the general holiday celebrations that we have next month. And obviously it applies directly to families when they're purchasing Christmas gifts to put under their tree or for one of the nights of Hanukkah or whatever. We understand all that. We understand what it covers, but that's a very limited amount of things. You know, what Pierre Poilievre should say is that instead of these little patchwork solutions for 2 months or 60 days, why not remove, say, the carbon tax, which basically costs Canadians an enormous amount? The price of the pumps has escalated beyond comprehension. It is still going higher. Some provinces like BC, it is now reaching the level on or beyond what the United States pays, but they pay by liters rather than our, you know, by gallons rather than our liters. That's what's so preposterous about this. There are many things that Justin Trudeau could do from his various environmental plans, you know, the carbon tax, as I said. There's a lot of things that they could remove that would actually help Canadians. They could make, you know, certainly rates more affordable. They could allow more trade liberalization, you know, open the skies, do anything to actually help the economy in general. This little thing with a GST moratorium for 2 months, it'll be gratifying to some people and every little bit helps. I understand that, but it's not going to fix our economy, which is in dire straits right now.
Okay. We'll be right back. I'm with Michael Tobe. We're expecting any moment to hear from Pierre Poilievre, the leader of the official opposition, expected to make some remarks in the House of Commons and react to this GST holiday announced by the Prime Minister, as well as a $250 check if you make less than $150,000 a year. $250 check on the way from the Government of Canada as well.
You have questions.
Now You Know with Rob Snow has the answers.
On News Radio.
So the Justin Trudeau Liberals have made a major announcement on affordability, a $6 billion plan. It includes removing the GST on a long list of items. Some of them are holiday related. Some of them are everyday essentials. And as well, the government is going to send $250 checks to every Canadian who worked in 2023 and earned up to $150,000. So the leader of the opposition is Pierre Poilievre, and he is responding to this announcement now. Just outside the House of Commons. Let's listen live here on News Radio.
NDP Liberals, everything is broken. And let's face it, the NDP Liberal coalition is back together. They've doubled housing costs, doubled the debt, doubled food bank use, doubled gun crime. With Jagmeet and Justin, it is double trouble for Canadians. Everything is broken. Life costs more. In fact, food prices have risen 36% faster in Canada than in the United States, a gap that opened up after the application of the carbon tax on the farmers and truckers who bring us our food. Now we have 2 million people lined up at food banks. This week we learned there has been a record increase in child poverty over the last year, all while Trudeau and the NDP made grand promises about childcare. 400,000 kids are forced to eat at food banks. One in four kids are not getting enough food, according to the government's own data. In fact, scurvy is making a comeback. Housing costs have doubled. Rent has doubled. Mortgage payments have doubled. Down payments have all doubled. And Trudeau's Housing Accelerator Fund, by his own admission, has not built a single solitary new home. 1,400 homeless encampments are now scattered across Ontario, 35 of them in Halifax alone. Our economy is cratering. It's dropped in per capita terms more than any other G7 country. Our per capita GDP is smaller than it was 10 years ago, even though during the same time the American per capita GDP has grown by 18%. Median incomes in our two countries were equal 10 years ago. Now they're $22,000 American bigger south of the border, where $500 billion net of our investment has poured to build pipelines, factories, businesses, and pay American paychecks with Canadian investment dollars after 9 years of Trudeau and the NDP Liberal tax increases and inflationary deficits. And the worst is yet to come. Trudeau and the NDP have voted for and legislated the quadrupling of the carbon tax to 61 cents a liter, which will stop our trucks from delivering parts to factories, clothing to stores, food to grocery shelves. It will mean billions more will pour across the border into the United States, millions of jobs will be lost, and a big smile will appear on Donald Trump's face as he picks up the phone from the Oval Office to call Canadian factories, trucking companies, mines, to tell them to go south 100 kilometers where there is no carbon tax and other taxes are dropping. The only thing worse than President Trump's tariffs are Prime Minister Trudeau's taxes. It's okay. Clear why Trump...
Pierre Poilievre, just outside the House of Commons and getting his reaction to the big GST announcement and $250 checks to Canadians sometime next year as well. More analysis of this major story in political Ottawa today, coming up right after the news with our Newsday panel here on News Radio.
No question goes unasked or unanswered.
Now You Know with Rob Snow returns on News Radio, the Newsday panel.
Well, it's time for our Newsday panel. Should be a good one today. Susan Smith, principal at Blue Sky Strategy Group, is with us. Hi, Sue.
Hi, Rob. Good morning. And, good lunchtime.
Yeah, great to hear from you. Tim Powers is here, chair of Summa Strategies, managing director at Abacus Data. How are you, Tim?
It's like the old gang is back together again, and now we can buy cheaper beer after December 14th.
I know. And ready-made cocktails, and the ready-made cocktails, and no GST on Christmas trees. I mean, happy holidays.
Stay healthy.
Happy holidays to everyone. So Mr. Poilievre has been reacting to this, been taking some reporters' questions, which is always adventurous, of course, when Mr. Poilievre greets the media. So let's listen to a little bit of it. David, go ahead, David.
You will vote against this, and if this is brought against us, you will vote against this measure if it's brought in the House of Commons?
We haven't seen the measure. We've seen his press releases. And if we believed NDP Liberal press releases, then we might have been tricked, as many in the media were, when they believed the rhetoric on the carbon tax. Remember they said the carbon tax would make you better off. And here we are with the food professor showing that food prices have risen 37% faster in Canada than in the U.S. a gap that opened up as the tax started applying here on the farmers and truckers who bring us our food. And of course, then the Parliamentary Budget Officer came out years after all of you wrongly reported and regurgitated Liberal talking points on the carbon tax. He came out and said, no, 100% of middle-class Canadians are worse off under the carbon tax, and 60% of all Canadians are worse off. So you're asking me if I'm going to vote for today's press release and press conference. I don't vote for press releases and press conferences. Canadians cannot eat press or live in press releases or press conferences. Let's see what they put before us. But I've got a better idea. Here's what I propose. When they come forward, put in the bill two ideas that will help forever. Axe the carbon tax, axe the GST on new homes.
I think that's good, Dave. Thank you very much. So let's get some. We don't need some immediate reaction to Mr. Poilievre just yet, but Sue, let's start with you and what you think about this Liberal proposal they're offering. I mean, it will have to pass through the House, but the NDP seems open to it. They're going to offer a GST holiday for 2 months on, you know, a specific list of items, and they're going to send next year. Every Canadian earning less than $150,000 in 2023 is going to get a check for $250. So what do you think of it all?
I'm glad we don't have to talk about Mr. Poilievre right away, Dave. It just makes me sad. Look, today's I'm often on talking to your listeners about the Liberals having to do something that impacts people's kitchen tables. And in one fell swoop today, they have directly done something that impacts people's kitchen tables or makes a difference on kitchen tables for people. Yeah, and pizza. Groceries, no more GST. Restaurants and fast foods, including pizza, no more GST. No more GST on kids' clothing, footwear, diapers, toys, beer and wine, and pre-mixed drinks, Christmas trees. They have done something with this move. It's a short-term move, but that there's directly an impact for absolutely every Canadian in this country because everybody buys food. And so I think Mr. Poilievre has actually been caught a little surprised. His idea with regards to axing GST on homes is not that people aren't going out and buying a new home every day, but they are going out and buying food every day for their family. So I think the Liberals have made an interesting move at an interesting time. It will actually hopefully unblock the jam in the House of Commons and get passed quickly. And I think it's something people will be talking about over the holidays in a positive way.
Okay. Tim Bowers, your thoughts, please.
You see this kind of stuff when governments are long in the tooth, and it's a move the Liberals had to make. It is a bit desperate. The question will be, and Susan touched on it, will it make enough of a difference with enough people that it will move the needle of the polls? And certainly that's what this is calculated to do. It is, you know, it's temporary, so you can hardly argue that it's sound policy. It may be reckless policy, as Pierre Poilievre was suggesting. And if I remember correctly, Rob, the proposal Mr. Singh was talking about last week and this week, the annual savings for Canadians in his proposal, and there are differences from what I hear, but we don't have any numbers, he was saying that would be about $500 annually. That's not, you know, that's not terrible, but I think that's not enough of what Canadians are looking for. So I don't know. The bigger challenge, though, for the Liberals is, again, the messenger and not the policy. I mean, the Liberals have tried a lot of different things to get people to connect with Justin Trudeau again, as he once was able to connect effectively. It just may not sell. I'm not sure if Justin Trudeau could offer each Canadian right now $1 million. And that would move people into the camp of the Liberals. But this is an attempt. Time will tell what it does.
Okay. Let me ask you about this idea, $250 checks. Now, you know, Doug Ford, it's really interesting because there's going to be an early election. I think everybody agrees. There's going to be an early election in Ontario sometime in the spring of next year, probably going to be an election in Ontario. So Doug Ford announced this plan. I'm going to send everybody $200 just before the election. And the Liberals in Ontario are like, Doug Ford is trying to bribe people just before an election. And here you have Mr. Trudeau. I'm going to send everybody $250. I guess probably before an election federally as well. What I find really interesting with this $250 check is that it's for everyone up to $150,000, up to $150,000, which seems kind of high to me. But maybe it's almost an admission that it's even hard out there for people who are making that kind of money. I don't know. What do you think about this idea? Let's send people money, Sue, $250.
Well, there's a couple things. Is it good politics? Perhaps. Is it good policy? That's another story. I personally am not a fan of sending people checks. Rob, you know, Ralph Klein did it years ago. Everybody went and bought TVs. That was a big joke about that at the time. There is no question that that money will make a difference for families. That is no joke. $250 coming in the door to a family at the right time, especially after the holidays, will absolutely make a difference for some families. So there's no diminishing that. I think the greater impact is this GST cut, because it's an instant daily revelation for people. And this is where again I say that I think Mr. Poilievre was caught surprised. I loved his comment, people don't vote for press conferences or press releases. Well, so far that's all he's put in the window. And the difference is the Liberals will be able to put this rebate in the window, or actually put it on the table for people. Yeah, and so that's where there is a gap. So from a political perspective, it's an okay move. From a policy perspective, I'm not so sure, but people aren't voting on policies. I think they're voting on what makes a difference to their families. And one last comment on something Tim said. I think all of the messengers are problematic these days. I don't think anybody loves Mr. Poilievre or Mr. Singh any more or less than they love Mr. Trudeau. The challenge with Mr. Trudeau and the Liberals is they've been around for a while, and that's just what happens. But by doing some creative things, they can cause people to think differently. And, you know, with our new friends in the South and the other options, I think these kind of moves...
Well, we'll talk about that. We'll talk about that. But we have to stop here, and I want to get Tim's take on money in the bank. I mean, I know what Tim's going to spend it on. He's going to spend it on beer and popcorn. But we'll talk about that when we come back.
Critical thinking is not dead.
Now You Know with Rob Snow.
Returns on News Radio.
Our Newsday panelists, Sue Smith from Blue Sky Strategy Group, Tim Powers from Summa Strategies, as we gather reaction to the affordability measures announced today by the Trudeau government. It's a GST break that starts on December 14th, ends on February 15th. It'll apply to a number of items: children's clothing, shoes, toys, diapers, restaurant meals, beer and wine, Christmas trees, a variety of snack foods and other beverages, and video game consoles. And Canadians who worked in 2023 earned up to $150,000. A $250 check will be yours come the spring. 18.7 million Canadians will be eligible to receive those checks. On the checks themselves, money, cold, hard cash. Tim, Justin, bucks coming your way. Gourmet popcorn and craft beer for you, my friend. What do you think about sending people cash? Very popular these days.
Rob, you and Susan's late father and I all hailed from Atlantic Canada. We used to do this with rum. I didn't know rum now cost $250. It's still cheaper to buy people with rum, or maybe the non-alcoholic version of it. Look, this is an old vote-buying scheme. You were talking about the threshold at 150. I do wonder if that's designed, yes, not just for people who are in that income bracket who are feeling it to be a little bit tighter, but more younger voters too, right? The ones who are facing the affordability crisis around homes and other areas. Justin Trudeau used to be very popular among millennials and Gen Zs. You know, they're pretty wise, that group. Unfortunately, neither you nor I nor Susan are in that group anymore, but I do think they're not going to be bought off by $250. I think they're going to need more, and it's going to be more than just the GST. It's going to be more than a housing accelerator. I mean, if he were wise, and then the three of us do remember this from the Kretschmann days, just really wanted to shake things up. take Poilievre's suggestion and bring that GST reduction or removal for homes under $1 million. Not sure that that's going to happen, but Mr. Cretchen used to beg, borrow, and steal from the Reform Party with great effect, and it worked. But with what's there now, not sure that's going to do much to change people's minds on the Prime Minister.
Okay. Did you have any closing words on this? I would mind moving along to the Abacus data poll, Sue, if you don't mind.
And you see Matt Gaetz has just pulled out, hey, Rob. Matt Gaetz has withdrawn his nomination.
Oh, really? Okay. Well, there must be something in that report then about that. Okay, so your firm, Abacus Data, is out with a new poll. It's a 22-point lead for the Conservatives. I guess the Liberals had been hoping for some kind of bump in support, despite because of Donald Trump's win in the United States presidential election. It hasn't materialized, at least not yet. But what are your takeaways from that poll, Tim?
I think you have to go back and look at data from a year and a bit ago when we started asking this question about whether or not Trump being elected was of political benefit to anybody. And in fact, really isn't to Mr. Trudeau anymore or to Mr. Poilievre, though more Canadians think Pierre Poilievre is better positioned to deal with Donald Trump. I think because enough Canadians' views about Mr. Trump are baked in, they don't necessarily conclude that somehow Justin Trudeau will have great impact against him or connection with him at this juncture. What happened in 2016 and onward after Mr. Trump got elected, I guess 2017 to be more precise, Mr. Trudeau was also new. He had early popularity. Trump, and he was starting to emerge as the leader of the kind of progressive forces in the world. Now he's 9 years in. Trump we've already had for 4 years. So I'm not surprised at all by the data that there's no Trump bump, because I don't think there would be one this go-round.
Okay. Sue, on the poll out today from Abacus Data, any big takeaways from that poll? Oh, Sue's phone dropped. Okay, we'll try to reconnect with Sue, but it's time for a break anyway. So let's stop here. And when we come back, hopefully we'll have Sue on. We'll get her thoughts on no Trump bump for the Liberals. And, that's the end of the line. Well, at least the end of his time in cabinet for strong Eagle man, Randy Boisseneau. Removed from the cabinet yesterday. They say he resigned. Was he pushed? We'll talk about that.
Now You Know with Rob Snow continues on News Radio.
Back for a few more minutes. Tim Powers here from Suma Strategies. Susan Smith from Blue Sky Strategy Group. Sue, I did want to get a comment from you on this Abacus data poll today. No Trump bump for the Liberals. What are your thoughts on that, Sue?
Yeah, a couple of things. I think it's a wait-and-see approach, actually. I mean, we're watching what's going on with the crazy nominations, and he's not in power yet. I don't know if there'll actually be a Trump bump, but I do think the NDP vote is kind of steady and if not soft. So I don't think that vote is going to move anywhere when Trump comes in. I think what people will see is how the experience Mr. Trudeau has and think about it in comparison to Mr. Poilievre in terms of handling Donald Trump. That's where people will be thinking about things. So I'm not worried about that at this point in time. The Trump bumpiness is about to come and we're all buckling up for that.
Okay. All right. Okay. Very interesting. Let's turn our attention to what happened yesterday with Randy Boisseneau. I'm using air quotes here, resigning from the cabinet. What did you think about how all of that played out? Tim Powers?
Well, that was an F in political management by the government. Randy, nice enough fellow. Let me just say that. But like, nice people, bad people, they get in trouble sometimes. They do things that they shouldn't have. And Randy went on this journey of indigeneity that didn't be connected to his what appears to be his history of indigeneity. And as we have seen through all manner of corporations, not-for-profits, universities, if you come forward and suggest that you are Indigenous and you don't have the history, the background to prove that, and then all of a sudden you switch your Indigenous identity, that rightly so should be a mark there that you step down and
deal with it. I don't know. I do know why he hung on so long. The Liberals don't have any cabinet ministers now in the West, and they don't have many seats in the West. Didn't help the prime minister. Maybe they were hoping they could get to cabinet shuffle and move Randy out. But it's a bit embarrassing for the government, particularly for a government that has spoken long and proudly about how it was trying to change the relationship with Canadian Indigenous peoples.
Sue, quick comment on this, please.
I would echo what Tim said about Randy Wasso being a good person. I actually know him, and he's a friend of mine, and he's a very decent human being. I think it took a long time to handle this issue. It does need to get sorted out. I'm confident that it will get sorted out. I think it's a very, very sensitive subject, of course, and I think what's happened, I think we need to see how it all shakes out. It's possible the story Randy has been told over time about his adopted family's history has evolved. And it's possible that that's why the narrative has evolved. But it should have been nipped, I think, more quickly in the bud. I'm confident it will be cleared up. And I think you will see Mr. Boisneau back after a period of time.
Okay, what does Mr. Trudeau do with an Alberta representative in cabinet now, Sue? What are his options?
Yeah, that's a good question. He could, it's a challenge because George Chahal mounted a challenge to the prime minister, so he would have been the obvious pick, but I think that's probably not on at the moment for obvious reasons. In the past, you could have pulled for the Senate, but the Senate is independent at this stage of the game. So I think he'll have someone with responsibility over the West. They'll hold the seat warm, and should Mr. Boisneau be able to clear the issues in a very short period of time, like I said, I think he can come back. But they'll spread the Western responsibilities, okay. I think, out.
Great to hear from both of you today. Thanks for joining us. Great to hear from you. Sue Smith from Blue Sky Strategy Group, Tim Powers from Summa Strategies on a very busy hour in news. And Talkback is just ahead to get your reaction to some of these stories.
It's time to talk back.
On Now You Know with Rob Snow.
Call now
and have your say.
1-833-668-2577.
Welcome to Talkback. 2 hours of debate and discussion on the big issues of the day. And we have a couple of topics for you today for you to think about. Give us a call. Share your opinion at 1-833-668-2577. 1-833-668-2577. The first is the big news of the day. This GST holiday that is coming courtesy of the Trudeau Liberals, although the NDP is bound to take credit for it. A GST holiday for 2 months on select items. There will also be $250 cheques coming your way in the new year from the Government of Canada if you made less than $150,000 during the year 2023. I really want your reaction to this. What do you think about this affordability measure announced today by Prime Minister Trudeau? Do you think it's a good idea? It will save Canadians money on everyday essential items and holiday items? Or do you think this is vote buying? And that this is political desperation from a prime minister leading a political party that is facing almost certain defeat in the next election. Please share your opinions on this. We have talked a lot this week about affordability, about the cost of living, about inflation, about how hard it is to make ends meet these days. And here is Prime Minister Trudeau saying, I am here to give you a break. I will suspend the GST on these items for 2 months, starting December 14th to February 15th. And then in the new year, you and your family can look forward to getting a check from the Government of Canada for $250. It is the biggest political story in Ottawa today, and we would really like to get your take on it at 1-833-668-2577, 1-833-668-2577. 668-2577. So that's one issue. Politics. Okay. That's one issue. Here's another. I really like your take on this too. This is more policy. You know, you have politics and policy. Here's another. In the United States, Donald Trump is going to have Elon Musk and a guy named Vivek Ramaswamy head what is being called a Doge committee. D-O-G-E, D-O-G-E, Doge. Doge is actually a meme coin in the cryptocurrency world. But in this case, they're saying it stands for Department of Government Efficiency. D-O-G-E, Department of Government Efficiency. And the news reports say it's going to be their job, these two guys from the private sector, to find and cut waste in government. So you have Elon Musk, wealthiest person in the world, Tesla, SpaceX, and Vivek Ramaswamy, also a successful entrepreneur. And they have said that they want to cut spending by the U.S. government by about $500 billion. $500 billion. There are news reports today that they're looking at cutting funding for PBS. They're looking at cutting funding for Planned Parenthood. They're looking at cutting funding for international organizations who want to cut regulations. They are talking about massive cuts. Ramaswamy has said his goal, I want to cut 50% of the U.S. federal workforce. Yes, 50% of the U.S. federal workforce. The U.S. government has 3 million employees. They say they want to eliminate entire government departments. They actually have an opinion piece in the Wall Street Journal today outlining some of their ideas, why they think it's important. They say they want to, quote, cut the federal government down to size. So here's a question for you. Given that this effort is going to be underway soon in the United States, we want to know, do you think we should have the same kind of committee here in Canada and do the same thing here in Canada? Should we have our own version of the Department of Government Efficiency that looks at ways to cut the size and cost and scope and complexity of our own federal government? You got these two guys, they're outsiders. They say in the Wall Street Journal today that, you know, we're entrepreneurs, we're not politicians. So if Canada was to do a similar thing, create its own Department of Government Efficiency to mirror what's going on in the United States, people are suggesting it should be run by individuals with proven records of success in the private sector, in business. Now, it's been in the news this year how the size of the federal government has significantly grown during Justin Trudeau's time as prime minister. When Justin Trudeau assumed office in 2015, we already had 250,000 people working for the federal government, just the federal government. And by last count, that had increased by more than 100,000 workers, 357,000 people working for just the federal government, costing just in compensation $67 billion a year. $67 billion a year. What do you think of this idea? Canada has its own version of DOGE, the Department of Government Efficiency. And it's not led by anyone in the government, but instead someone with serious success in the private sector. You think that's a good idea, bad idea? Those are our topics today. A two-month GST holiday coming on basics and essentials, and a $250 check coming your way next year, courtesy of the Trudeau Liberals. What do you think of that idea? And should Canada have the Department of Government Efficiency led by some successful entrepreneur?
Have something on your mind you want everyone to know?
Call now.
Hello.
1-833-668-2577.
It's Talk Back on Now You Know with Rob Snow.
Two topics today, a GST holiday and a Department of Government Efficiency. The Trudeau Liberals are going to cut the GST for 2 months on some essential items. So you get a holiday break from the GST, and the next year, if you earned less than $150,000 in 2023, you're going to get a check for $250. What do you think of that idea? Good idea? Save you money? Or a desperate move from a desperate politician? And in the United States, they're going to have something called the Department of Government Efficiency, going to be led by Elon Musk and Vivek Ramaswamy, and their goal is to cut the federal government down to size. Should Canada have its own Department of Government Efficiency? 1-833-668-2577. Mike in Calgary up first. What's your opinion, Mike? Jump right into it here.
Hey, Rob. When I look at Justin Trudeau, I think of a quote from Mr. O'Leary. Justin Trudeau couldn't manage a candy store. He is such a I just look at him and I get like disgusted. Whatever, what is, you know, what, every time he comes up with some new thing to try to get people to vote for him, he's just such a clown. And when it comes to like cutting back on like government, you know, situations, like you said in the United States, I think that's a pretty good idea. Like, I mean, I think we have way too many politicians in this country.
Well, it's not so much, you know, just the politicians. It's just the size of the government and what it is costing and the complexity of just the government bureaucracy. That's what they're looking at. They're not really looking at the number of politicians, but just the absolute size and scope of the government these days.
Okay, yeah, I think that's a good idea because, I mean, like you said, like there's over like 100,000 more people working for the government, like you said, since Justin Trudeau got in.
Yeah, just the federal government. Yes, yes.
Yeah, that's just like pathetic. I mean, this is way too many. Like, just too much. I mean, you know,
but what do you think about this? I got you. Let's circle back to this GST thing. This is really interesting. Children's clothing, footwear, diapers, car seats, toys for children under the age of 14, newspapers, books, Christmas trees. Aren't you putting up a Christmas tree? Mike, don't you want to save money on a Christmas tree? You're not going to have to pay the GST on your Christmas tree or your chips or your beer. And you're going to get a $250 check.
But, to me, whatever, like it's just a short fix. I mean, like, get rid of the carbon tax.
Good point.
Like that would be a long term.
Short fix. Good stuff, Mike. Thank you. All right. You've got us off and running here. Let's go to Josie in Calgary. Hi, Josie. What's your opinion? I'd love to hear your opinion.
Okay. Hi, Rob. This is my first call. I just want you to know that I have a very strong opinion of what's happening in Canada right now. The smoke and mirrors, I want every single 17-year-old that's going to be turning 18 next year and every single new-to-Canada human being to understand this was your money in the first place. So this is something that's just, it absolutely is disgusting that he's using this as bait vote, and I hope everybody dials into this. This is your money to begin with. He stole it from you, and he's given it back, thinking that you're going to be suckered in.
Okay, so he's bribing voters with their own money, then?
100%. That's exactly 100%. What this is. He is in a place right now where his party is out next year. As far as Singh goes, if I was NDP, I would be disgusted with what he has done to Canada by keeping Justin in there. This is, and it's not to say if I was, for Poilievre, as far as I'm concerned, I've been on this planet for almost 60 years, and it's cyclical. Rob, you know it's cyclical. We're going to get another government in, and then in 4 or 5 years, we're going to start seeing the same thing. So with certainty, government needs less impact on our society as far as control, government overreach. We need to be in charge of what we're doing and what we're seeing. That means less government. That means less expenses. They have, this is just a boy who is trying to run the country on a silver spoon. It's a trust account, and he's pretending that it's his money, and it's not. It's our money.
All right. Thank you for your opinion, Josie in Calgary. Good to hear from you. 1-833-668-2577. 1-833-668-2577. Okay. We're talking about a GST holiday and a Department of Government Efficiency. Some people say we should have a Department of Government Efficiency in Canada. Brad, what's your opinion? Brad, share your opinion. Go ahead.
Hey, Rob. I like your show. I'm just kind of thinking about the mechanics of this and how it's going to go. You know, we're all familiar with how
liberals make these wonderful announcements and they get all the media coverage on it, but how's it going to come down the pipe? If I go to Walmart and I buy a coffee pot and I'm paying GST on that, but I'm buying $100 worth of groceries and that's going to be exempt of GST, where does that occur? At the till? Because that's going to cause a problem for the realtors and their systems and their accounting and whatnot. Or am I just going to pay that GST and then claim it on my taxes later? You know, it seems like a typical Trudeau trap.
Okay. Yeah, we're already getting, you know, various inputs from some business organizations. Brad, and I thank you for your call, Brad, in Calgary. That this could create some headaches, you know, having to, whatever, reprogram cash registers and, you know, scanners and whatnot. And, you know, the CFIB is already expressing some concern that consumers might hold off on purchases now. Why would you buy something now in this category, you know, children's clothing, footwear, diapers, toys, Christmas trees? What? Why would you buy that stuff now if you could just wait till December 14th? And buy it on December 14th. Very interesting. Okay, when we come back, more of your calls on these two topics, the GST holiday and a Department of Government Efficiency in Canada. They're going to do that in the United States, have a DOGE committee, Department of Government Efficiency, to cut the federal government down to size. And some people think maybe we should do that here. What do you think?
Have something on your mind you want everyone to know?
Call now.
Hello.
1-833-668-2577.
It's Talk Back on Now You Know with Rob Snow.
Mr. Trudeau's playing Santa Claus. You will get a two-month GST holiday on some essential items and holiday-related items. And next year, the government of Canada will send you a check for $250. Love your thoughts on that. Meantime, in the United States, Elon Musk and a guy named Vivek Ramaswamy will lead something called the Department of Government Efficiency, with the stated goal of cutting the federal government down to size. Should Canada have a Department of Government Efficiency? Your thoughts, please. Wade, what do you think of all of these things? Wade, you're on the line. Go ahead, Wade.
Hey, Rob, I got to be quick. I'm on my old Motorola flip phone, and I'm distracted driving. As far as that offer goes from Trudeau, first of all, I don't trust that guy as far as I could throw him. And as far as the DOGE, I think that is a great idea. We should have one in Canada, and they should change him up every couple of years to make sure that people don't start lining up at the pig trough.
All right. Thank you, Wade. I'll let you go since you're on the road there. Michael, up next, calling from Calgary. Michael, what's your opinion on these topics today, Michael? Go ahead.
Well, I think a good analogy of what Trudeau is doing is like he buys a bag of candy with your money and leaves you the wrapper, or cuts your arms off and slaps you in the face with it. For that, as far as him helping out with the cost of living. And as far as the Deutsch goes, I'd like to see that happen, but who's going to let that happen in the government? That's like, you know, getting the fox to guard the hen house. That'll never happen because you're cutting into their, you know, into their ways of spending money. That's
well, I think, Michael, if I could just interrupt, I think the vision would be you don't have somebody in the government do it. You do it the way Trump is doing it. You get people from the outside with some serious private sector experience who know how to run a successful business, and you get them to take a look at it. You don't let the bureaucrats do it. You
know? I get that for sure, but who's going to let them in, like, to do that? They'll put up such a stink and fight that to the bitter end and cost the taxpayers a few more billion dollars fighting that, right? No, that's the way it is here. They've got, government has got government bias to their ways, so tied up. I can't see that them letting that ever happen. But
good idea, but not going
to
happen.
On that
okay.
I'd
love to be on that committee.
Oh, yeah. Okay. All right. I'll take my income from 0.001% of the money I save the taxpayers, and I'll be a national hero.
Oh, I see. Okay, you'll just take a small little commission on whatever you save the taxpayers. So, okay, that's great. Yeah. It'd be a good gig for you, I bet. Yeah, it'd be a good gig.
Oh,
okay, Michael. Yeah, you put a smile on my face there with that last idea. Okay. Maybe I should make that pitch myself. 1-833-668-2577. Look, you're going to get a GST holiday courtesy of old St. Nick. I mean, Justin Trudeau. 2 months, you won't pay the GST on a number of items. And he's going to send you a $250 check next year. Meantime, in the United States, they're going to have the Department of Government Efficiency to cut the federal government down to size. Should we have the same thing here? Your thoughts after the news on News Radio.
Have something on your mind you want everyone to know?
Call now.
Hello.
1-833-668-2577.
It's Talk Back on Now You Know with Rob Snow.
So the Prime Minister was in Toronto today and announced a GST exemption for essential items, a GST holiday for 2 months. Let me run the list down. Children's clothing, footwear, diapers, car seats, select toys for kids under the age of 14, including puzzles and video games, print newspapers and printed books, natural and artificial Christmas trees, food items including chips, candy, baked goods, all prepared meals, catered meals, beverages including pop, bottled water, beer and wine, and coolers with up to 7% alcohol. So in addition, so that's going to be in place for 2 months starting December 14th, February 15th. And then the government will send every Canadian who worked in 2023 and earned up to $150,000. You will get a check for $250. What do you think of that idea? Okay. In the United States, meantime, Elon Musk and Vivek Ramaswamy, two Trump guys, are going to lead something called DOGE, Department of Government Efficiency. And they say they are going to cut the size of the U.S. government down to size. Should Canada have a Department of Government Efficiency led by some successful entrepreneur? What do you think? 1-833-668-2577. Let's go to Stephanie in Nova Scotia. Hi, Stephanie. What's your opinion, Stephanie? Go ahead.
Hi. I guess, my two cents is, first of all, the Department of Government Efficiency, I find, is a little hilarious that it's going to be run by two people, which seems kind of highly inefficient. But also, it's going to be outsiders that are billionaires that really have their own interests in mind and don't really care about the people, which is also interesting that everyone else is for reducing the government, but then this adding this department is like, totally, let's bring that in. So I don't know, I think that eliminating government, like, we as people, we overthrew monarchs and implemented governments because they're supposed to be there for the people, protecting the people. They work for us, right? So
okay
So I think that less government is worse for Canadians and really anyone, everyone.
Okay.
Yeah. And also, I think it's a nice gesture from Trudeau. I think it will help a lot of families here. I think it's too little too late. I'm not going to vote Trudeau again, but I don't think the answer to that is the Conservatives. I think the NDP are the option. I think that...
Fair enough.
Yeah, will be the best for the people in the long run. So,
okay, very good. You know, you're in the minority opinion today, Stephanie. I think
I know.
But, I really appreciate it.
It's
good to get that contrarian view out there. I really appreciate your call. Thank you so much for sharing your opinion today, Stephanie. And call again from Nova Scotia. Let's go to I believe we have Tim up next in Calgary. Go ahead, Tim. Thank you for calling. What's your opinion?
Hey, Rob. How's your day going?
Everything is fine. Well, it's a little wet here today, but we're not having the cold like Calgary is having. So I don't have to shovel the rain, you know, so that's okay.
Sounds good. Yeah, well, first up, I guess with just inflation there and his overspending habits, you know, we may all have overspending habits, but his are in the hundreds of billions, right? So you know, with regards to, I don't know if it's called stealing all our money or what it's called, Rob, but, you know, there's $250 back. I don't think at this point it's going to help anyone. And it's just, you know, all this gaslighting, I think we're all done with it, right? So,
well, let's think about it, though. I mean, let's say, you know, you worked and it's $250 and your spouse worked and they get $250,000. Maybe you have somebody, you know, an older child in the house, you know, an 18, 19, 20 year old, and they work, they're going to get $250. That's going to be $750 coming to you. It's not bad.
You know, at this point, let's just print all the money and just, you know,
okay,
drive the cost of everything sky higher. Right. So anyway, okay, those are my thoughts on that side of things.
Yeah, no, fair enough. I mean, all of these measures that they just kind of came up with, I don't know how much thought they've put into this.
It's not going to gain
$6.2 billion to do this. $6.2 billion to do this. I mean, it's a lot of money.
It's right? Ludicrous, Rob. It's ludicrous.
And it's money that's not going into, you know, whatever your chosen priority is. Money that's not going to affordable housing. Or getting people out of homeless encampments. It's not money that's not going into the healthcare system. I mean, it's money that's going into your pocket. And, you know, so, but okay. Thank you. Appreciate that.
Thank you.
Good to hear from you today. Yeah. Appreciate it. Bernie in Mississauga. Hello, Bernie. Good to hear from you, Bernie. What do you think about the news today?
Another kudos out to Mr. Jagmeet Singh for getting this measure passed. It was his idea. So with the dental care and the pharmacare program, I think he's accomplished a lot with only 22 seats in the House of Commons. And as far as I think it's a good thing. Every little thing helps, especially around this time of year, Christmas time. So I think it's a good move. And one thing I've noticed, Rob, these Tories are so angry. But what are they so angry about? They're way ahead in the polls, but they seem to be very nasty in their comments. They're not, they're spiteful. They don't seem to
Well, I think they want an election. I think that's the frustration, Bernie. I think they want an election, you know. They're sick of the government. They want a new government. That's what it is. They don't think this government has done a very good job.
Elon Musk being the head of the efficiency in the United States government, I say there shouldn't be a capitalist in there to look after efficiency. They should have someone from the universities or somebody from a professor or something like that. It should come from the ordinary people. It shouldn't come from the ones that put us in the position we're in, the capitalists.
Okay, now, Bernie, just before you go, you know, this doesn't go as far as what the NDP outlined a week ago, and I believe you called me and we talked about it then. You know, the NDP wanted breaks on cell phones and internet subscriptions, but the big one was home heating. You know, winter's coming, it's getting cold, and this doesn't include home heating. Do you think that's a shortfall for the announcement from Mr. Trudeau?
Well, I don't know.
Trudeau?
Like I said before, there's 22 seats. The Tories got over 150 seats. And what had they accomplished? What have they fought for to eliminate the average person in this country since they've been in opposition?
They've been fighting to try and get the carbon tax eliminated. They want to get rid of the carbon tax.
Carbon tax is a good thing. You look around the world and look at the disasters that are happening. They got to do something about carbon emissions. And then people get a rebate. It's not that bad. It's not as bad as the Tories are making it out to be.
All right. Thank you, Bernie. Good to hear from you. Yep. And again, I think that view, along with Stephanie's view in Nova Scotia so far, is the minority opinion. It is interesting. Bernie's in, you know, the GTA and Stephanie's in Atlantic Canada. And most of the callers today who are in opposition and view this Trudeau move as desperate vote buying are calling from Western Canada. From Calgary and the Calgary area.
Have something on your mind you want everyone to know?
Call now.
Hello.
1-833-668-2577.
It's Talk Back on Now You Know with Rob Snow.
On the GST holiday, the $250 check, the Department of Government Efficiency, let's go to Robert in Calgary. What's your opinion on these issues today, Robert?
Well, good morning, Rob. It's still morning here. I'd like to discuss the bonus check. And if I had made $149,000 last year, I really don't think I need $250 now. If I only made $100,000 last year, again, I don't think I need $250. As opposed to, why not if I only made $50,000 last year, then or under, then give me $750. That's where the impact of this bonus check should go, is to the lower middle class.
Yeah, and think about this, because they're sending going to send this check, they calculate to more than 18 million Canadians are going to qualify for this. So, you know, as I said to the last caller, let's say you, Robert, you make $149,999 a year. Okay, you've made pretty good money. You're going to get a check from the government for $250. Let's say your spouse made $149,999 a year. They're going to get a check for $200,000 a year. So you have a household income of $300,000. Do you really need checks from the government totaling $500?
Not at all. Again, if I was under $50,000, that's
right.
The people that need the money, and give them triple the amount, not $250, give them $750, because they'll need a lot more than my, and I'm a retired senior, I have no skin in the game here. I did not work in 2023. I'm just saying, let's help out the people that really need the $750.
Yeah, very good. Very good point. Yeah, it should be means tested, right? And this isn't really all that means tested. Means tested mean, you know, send it to people who don't have the means. To somebody who is making $150,000 a year, just shy of, $1 shy of, do they really need a check from the government for $250? I hear you. All right,
and
let's
like,
from Calgary.
Like you
yeah,
said,
thank
if
you.
There's three people in that family, they're making like $500,000, and they don't need any money.
Okay. Thank you, Robert. Thank you. Matthew in Halifax is up next. Looking forward to hearing from Matthew. Matthew, what's your opinion on these moves?
Hey, yo. I've got a minority opinion.
Okay.
The check, how is that going to help the people that are severely marginalized? They've already fallen through the cracks. Being autistic myself, I have a rather high interest in helping advocate for persons with disabilities. Sorry about the noise.
That's okay.
Roads here in Halifax, they're under maintenance. Anyway, a lot of people will say that the pendulum has swung too far. And all the time, there's a big change. The pendulum has swung too far again. I think making big changes in the government to improve efficiency, okay, I understand that. Making it more effective, sure. America would like that if there is a way to make sure that the military is funded as to the appropriate level that they think we need to. We're doing more with less, and the people that are marginalized by society, well, they continue to be even deeper marginalized. Ford is getting rid of their diversity, inclusion, equity ways of doing things. I didn't see anything about accessibility, but the Accessible Canada Act is here to help encourage a better way forward. So I don't want to see people with disabilities get even further marginalized.
Yes.
So.
Yes. Okay. I guess when it comes to, you know, something like a Department of Government Efficiency, I'll have some thoughts on this as we make our way through the hours. But I guess, you know, you say we're doing more with less. But when it comes to the government, I wonder if they're doing less with more. Mr. Trudeau has added 100,000 workers to the government payroll. Okay, just in the federal government. But is this any easier to access services? Have government services dramatically improved because 100,000 people have been added to the payroll? I would also point out that while Mr. Trudeau was adding 100,000 people to the payroll, that spending on outside consultants, firms consulting to the government, crafting policy for the government that should be done by the federal public service has increased 60% during his time in office and has hit a record high of almost $18 billion. So not only has he grown the size of the federal bureaucracy, but he has also spent more money than any other government before him on outside consultants. Are you really getting better service with this increase in the size of the federal bureaucracy? That would be my question to you.
I would say no, because even the internal mechanisms to help provide grassroots understanding of the people that are affected by the policies, I don't think that they are efficiently listened to, because there are employment equity groups in every branch of government that could provide the women's perspective, the LGBT perspective, visible minority perspective, indigenous and persons with disabilities understanding of just within the employee base of the government, how things affect them. And in terms of the service they provide also to those.
Okay.
Is it really efficient to
Okay, I have to run. Thank you. Thank you, Matthew. I understand where you're coming from, Matthew. I understand where you're coming from, but I have to let you go because we're actually a bit over time now. So we'll have to wrap up our conversation there.
Have something on your mind you want everyone to know?
Call now.
Hello.
1-833-668-2577.
It's Talk Back on Now You Know with Rob Snow.
We've been talking about the GST holiday, $250 checks, maybe a Canadian version of DOGE, this Department of Government Efficiency that Trump wants to do, led by Elon Musk and Vivek Ramaswamy in the United States. Look, we're only going to have probably time for one call here. If you're on the line, I encourage you to stay on the line. We'll get to you in hour number two right after the news at the top of the hour. Russ in High River, what's your opinion here, Russ?
We'll make it quick. I'm good, thank you. There we are, liberals trying to buy you with your own money. People get sucked into that. There's something wrong. I think they're desperate to get Parliament back, and they're trying to force the Conservatives back to make say, look, the Conservatives won't let us give you this GST holiday on. Most people are done Christmas shopping by the middle of December anyway. And that $250 is I don't know, is just a joke. I can't believe this. People would even think that
just a joke.
The liberals
okay.
think this. You know, it's there. I don't know. I watched Christine Freeland there making it.
Okay.
She just drives me nuts because I don't even think she was a school teacher, but she talks to Canadians like they're 12 months old, just coming out of the womb. Oh, well, you know, their hands and Trudeau there nodding his head. I'm sorry. Let's just call an election mm-hmm. and get all this over with and see what happens.
Okay, I got it. That, it's very expensive, you know, almost $6.3 billion worth. $6.3 billion. What, do you have any opinion on maybe Canada having a Department of Government Efficiency?
Yes, but they should. Shouldn't report to the government. It should report to an outside auditor. Some outside auditor, I don't know who they report to, but maybe a group of politicians, but not to the ruling government. That's like asking the liberals to audit themselves. Cripes, they have an audit on that green fund they won't even release because it's so crooked.
Okay, thank you for your call in High River today. I hope you're well there, Russ. Wow, very quick first hour. We took a lot of calls. Let's keep it going in hour number two.
It's time to talk back.
On Now You Know with Rob Snow.
Call now.
And have your say.
1-833-668-2577.
So a couple of hot topics here. Topic number one is this holiday break from the GST that the Trudeau Liberals announced today. And there's going to be a check in the mail for you, or maybe direct deposit. $250 check from the government. The GST thing is supposed to come into effect December 14th. It has the support of the NDP. It includes, some prepared foods at grocery stores, beer and wine, diapers, children's clothing, children's shoes, car seats, toys. What else is on this list? Newspapers, Christmas trees, chips, candy, baked goods. And I mentioned beer and wine, also coolers. 7% alcohol content is the max on the coolers. Does not include things like internet bills, cell phone bills, or home heating bills, as was demanded by the NDP. So on that, too bad, so sad, put on a sweater. And it's not going to be permanent. As I said, it will be in effect until the middle of February. And as for the checks, $250, they will hit your bank account in the spring for anyone who worked in 2023 and earned an income of less than $150,000. You'll get a check for $250. Is that how bad the cost of living is? You make $149,999 a year. Even you're going to get a check for $250. So that is one topic. The other is this. I just find it interesting. What do you think about this idea? DOGE for Canada, Department of Government Efficiency, not led by people in government, but led by people with some serious success in the private sector. Trump administration is going to do this. Okay. Elon Musk, you know, Elon Musk, Tesla, SpaceX, Vivek Ramaswamy, also a successful entrepreneur. They're going to be in charge of something called the Department of Government Efficiency. They're going to take chainsaws, they say, to the size of the federal government in the United States. Massive cuts, hundreds of thousands, if not millions of job cuts in the federal public service in the United States, where about 3 million people work for the government of the United States. This Ramaswamy guy said they think they could cut that in half. Now, some have suggested we should do the same thing here in Canada. We should have people with a great track record of success in the private sector come in, take a look at how this federal government operates, spends money, then take an axe to it. What do you think about that idea? Two ideas for you to think about. Give us a call at 1-833-668-2577. Let's go to Debbie on the line. Debbie, what's your opinion? Go ahead.
Hi, Rob. Far as DOGE goes, I think it's an excellent idea. I'm sure there's a lot of places that can be cut back in the government and the government spending. So I think there's no negative to that, as long as we get the right people in there, you know, that will be nonpartisan. And now, as far as the $250 goes, I agree with the caller that said, let's bring that down to, you know, people who maybe make $75,000 and under and maybe make it $500. People over that really don't need $250. And now, as far as the GST goes, I'm looking at the list, and it's kind of off-putting that they have excluded recreational gear, which is super expensive for people who have children and are trying to get them into hockey or whatever. But okay, you've got lots of games and you've got lots of crap food, chips, crisps, puffs, curls, or sticks. You know, so let's get these kids sitting on their butt more, eating all this crap, but let's not give them a break on athletic equipment. That, to me, is just ridiculous. That's where these people really need it. Hockey, ringette, whatever, is super expensive to get your kids into, and the equipment is ridiculous. So let's save some GST on that and give people a hand.
Yeah, it'll be skiing season soon enough as well, right? You know,
maybe Mr. Trudeau's having a big Christmas party or something. I don't know, but there's a lot of stuff on here that, okay, to me, we don't need to save the GST on. Just don't buy that stuff, you know, whereas, like Mr. Singh initially suggested, let's get it off of the necessities. You know, this to me, like, is it's helpful, and it's Christmas, and everybody overspends at Christmas, so this will be helpful, but it's not, and it's not long-term. It really is a little Christmas present.
Old Christmas present. Stocking stuffers. Okay, thank you, Debbie. Good to hear from you. Where are we going? David? Is it Jonathan?
Jonathan.
Yes. Okay. Thank you, David. Jonathan. Hi there, Jonathan. Thanks for waiting. You're on the air. What's your opinion?
Hi. Good morning, Rob. Yeah, I agree.
Good to hear from you.
I agree with the first caller, but you know what? In my opinion, I think Trudeau really want to play his tricks again. Like, and if you notice all the list, it's strategic, where majority of the voters are targeted. Everything, if you, to me, it's like very strategic. And You know, he's giving a lollipop to a crying child, you know, and I hope this okay, will not. Okay. I hope this will not change the majority of us during the time of the election. And it's very obvious that this is to. He already started trying to save himself, and you know, and before I. His tricks works, but I hope this time it will not work. We can accept the gifts and this previous and everything. It's our money actually too, but it doesn't spend to the more important government programs. But it is what it is. But I hope it will not change. Our views towards the next election.
Okay, thank you very much for sharing your opinion. We will stop here and more of your calls just ahead.
Have something on your mind you want everyone to know?
Call now.
Hello.
1-833-668-2577.
It's Talk Back on Now You Know with Rob Snow.
Been waiting quite some time, been very patient, so right to the phones. Timothy in Calgary, you are on the air. What's your opinion, Timothy, on the GST holiday, a $250 check, a Doge committee for Canada? Go ahead.
Well, I want to start again by saying thank you for your show. It's quite entertaining because I drive around quite a bit. And I love your callers. There's a wide range of people, you know, that come in with different opinions. Like somebody said, by December 14, Christmas shopping is done. I put my tree out December 1st. So this break on the GST, you know, it's coming out. It's just political, I would say. And don't get me wrong, I'm liberal. I love Justin Trudeau. But will I vote for him again? Mm. Maybe not. You know, anybody okay. but him, you know. So, but anybody yeah, I just feel like okay. it's a bit of a political stunt. Too little, too late. Hey, but... with regards to the check, maybe you can be able to buy that steak. That steak, that cut of steak you mentioned yesterday, just maybe you know, indulge when you get that check, hopefully, right?
Okay, maybe, maybe I can buy a steak, one. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. No, all right. But back to the Department of Government Efficiency. Yeah, thanks. Because I do listen, but I can't call in every day. But I love your show. I love your people. It's fun. In terms of the Department of Government Efficiency, okay. well, I guess Canada could use some, you know, definitely, especially with the over 100,000 people that have been hired in such a short amount of time, while external consulting has equally gone up. You would think that if they're hiring more people, then there should be a cutback on the external consulting. So it's like, so yeah, definitely it would help. Maybe not as harshly as in the U.S. where they want to cut off 50% of government employees. I think, you know, I don't think we can deal with that here. But definitely, I think we would need something like that in Canada as well. So, yeah.
All right. Very interesting. Timothy, thank you for your call and your kind words. I really appreciate it. You know, that's something that I was thinking about. You know, this, I appreciate it, Timothy. Thank you. Thank you. To Timothy's point, though, GST, saving the GST on a Christmas tree, but it doesn't come into effect until December 14th. I mean, my Christmas tree will be up long before December 14th, long before 10 days before Christmas. You know, I do wonder if you did some kind of survey, when do you put your Christmas tree up? I bet you most people put it up well before December 14th. I actually wonder what this will mean for Christmas Day sales. Not only sales of real trees, but sales of artificial trees. People going to Canadian Tire or Walmart getting an artificial tree. Are all the Christmas tree purchases now on hold until 10 days before Christmas? Like David, are you busy? Yeah. David, I mean, when do you put your tree up?
Well, a lot of our male listeners might.
You must put your tree up before December 14th.
Yeah, a lot of men may relate to this, but I'm not in charge of that decision in my house, and it happens a long time before December 14th. I can tell you that much for free.
So, all right, let's take Tom's call. Tom is up next. You're on the air, Tom. Share your opinion on these issues today, Tom. Go ahead.
First-time caller. My opinion on this is that, you know, it is a bit of a Christmas gift. You know, the GST was brought in by the by Brian Mulroney, which sort of removed the tax system we ever had in place. So I don't know why we have, why we paid 15%. Now we're down to 13%. Alberta has no sales, provincial sales tax. So this being done, it is going to help in a sense, because there are people out there who could use this, use the break on taxes, buying groceries and that. Absolutely. As a senior, I know I can go to the grocery store, and the timing is a little questionable. Why December 4th? Why not December 5th? You know, maybe they, and maybe Mr. Trudeau will come back and say, you know, so maybe we're going to start it earlier and it's going to run to February. But, you know, it's, you know, to me, it's better than nothing. It just also prove, it does prove to me something, is that if they can do this for 2 months and give people that, how much more could this go further? You know, and as regarding Mr. Poilievre saying he would take the GST off of home, why don't we just reduce the GST altogether from that standpoint? Why do we have to just put it on one item? Why don't we just reduce the GST together? Why don't we say seniors don't pay taxes anymore? Because the simple reason is that the economy may get better, may not get better, but people are still going to struggle. And one of your callers before that, the people who are marginalized, who are falling through the cracks, this is not going to help them at all. Not one bit. And maybe this $250 that Mr. Trudeau is going to give us, and if it could go to somewhere else, if everybody would donate $50 that to a non-profitable charity, maybe that could go to better use.
Okay, but to your point, I you know, and I wonder, because, are you in Ontario? I believe you're calling from Ontario.
Yes,
you. So, for example, Doug Ford in Ontario had a gas. He has a gas tax holiday, right? And he originally announced that to take 5 cents. I believe it's 5 cents a liter off the gas tax that he took off.
Yep.
And then it came up. It was supposed to expire, and he extended it. Right. And then it came up again, and he extended it again. Because he doesn't want to certainly raise the price of gas before he calls an early election. I wonder, you know, this is supposed to expire on the 15th of February.
Right.
I wonder if it will be extended beyond that.
Well, again, that's what I'm saying. I think maybe this is just a way, this is a test to see how popular it is and what it's going to do to the economy. Because let's face it, if you're not paying taxes on certain items, you're going to spend more. No, I am. You know, if I can go to the grocery store and spend $100 in groceries and not be taxed on that, I'm going to spend a little bit more. If I can buy grandchildren clothes and not get taxed on it, I'm going to spend a little bit more. So it does sort of stimulate the economy in one way. And that's what I'm saying. Maybe it's just a ploy to figure out, well, let's see how what this does, and maybe we can extend this further. Because in all honesty, I'm saying, like, we had a tax system way before that. We didn't have this GST. We just went to the store. Whatever it cost you paid was a dollar, you paid a dollar. And all of a sudden someone came along and said, well, now it's going to cost you a dollar plus 15%. So, you know, I don't know why that ever happened, why it changed.
Well,
it really
was plus 7%. It was because you have to keep in mind the provincial sales tax, right? The GST, and there's GST and PST, right? The GST is 5%, and then the provinces have their own taxes. In Alberta, there's no PST in Alberta. Okay, got to run. A little tight on time here. Thank you, though, for your call, Tom. Some interesting points. Can't say I agree with all of them, but appreciate them nonetheless. 1-833-668-2577. It is TalkBack here on News Radio.
Have something on your mind you want everyone to know?
Call now.
Hello.
1-833-668-2577.
It's TalkBack on Now You Know with Rob Snow.
All of a sudden, it's Christmas in November. Mr. Trudeau playing Santa Claus today, announcing a GST holiday on select items. Now, it doesn't start in November. It actually doesn't start until the middle of December. It will last for 2 months until the middle of February. And then sometime early next year, as long as you didn't make more than $150,000 in the year 2023, the federal government is going to send you a check for $250. It's been a hot topic today, along with this idea that they have in the United States for the Department of Government Efficiency. Some people think we should do that in Canada. Let's go to Mike in Calgary, first-time caller. Thanks for calling, Mike. What's your opinion, Mike? Go ahead.
I just wanted to say I love your show, first-time caller. I listen to it every day.
Thank you.
Well, as far as the Doge goes, I think that could be a good idea. There's always room for fat to be trimmed. So people make ridiculous amounts of money and seem like they don't do a heck of a whole lot for anybody but themselves.
Okay.
Now, as far as the $250 goes for GST, if you're making $150,000 a year, you definitely shouldn't need it. I mean, I make less than 50, and I mean, I'm comfortable. I mean, I don't need it myself, but I mean,
right,
money is
right.
always good.
But you think that limit is too high of $150,000? If somebody's making $149,999, they don't need $250 check from the government, right?
No, if they need that, then they're living like
Well, they're living beyond their means.
Yeah. There's people that could really use that money more than they can.
Yeah. You'll get no argument from me on that. I think it's a bit high. I was quite taken aback by that threshold. I mean, that's either an oversight or they want to kind of bribe as many people as they possibly can because they're sending 18 million, or they just have really no understanding of the real need that is out there.
Well, and that there's lots of need. Like one of your callers said, maybe getting rid of taxing, seniors that are living on pensions. They've been paying into it for years.
Yeah, I understand that. We had a big argument about that a few weeks ago. They've paid probably more than their fair share of taxes, but they're also the wealthiest generation. A lot of them bought homes for $100,000 that are worth $1 million now.
Something on your mind you want everyone to know?
Call now.
Hello.
1-833-668-2577.
It's Talk Back on Now You Know with Rob Snow.
So we've been discussing two issues today. One is the GST holiday coupled with the $250 check on the way from the government of Canada, courtesy of the Trudeau Liberals. They're going to cut the GST starting December 14th on some essential items going to be in place until the middle of February. So you get a holiday break from the GST, and sometime in the new year, early in the new year, it's a $250 check from the government. Now, David has some details on actually who qualifies for that $250 check, because we have been saying incomes up to $150,000 will get the $250 check from the government based on their 2023 employment. I was under the impression, David, that that was gross income, but it's not gross income, is it?
That's the impression that I was under as well, just based on the language the Prime Minister used in his announcement. But I have in front of me the backgrounder material for the media from the Department of Finance, and it says here, quote, "Eligible for the tax-free 250 rebate are all Canadians who worked in 2023, earned up to $150,000 individual net income," end quote.
Wow, net income. So after tax income, my goodness gracious. I mean, how much money do you have to make in a year to net $150,000, David? I mean, I would have to think almost $300,000 or something like that.
I plugged it into just a basic online tax calculator and, rounding some numbers, don't quote me exactly on this, but you can make up to $250,000 a year in Ontario and net $148,000. So if your base salary is $250,000, you're getting a check for $250 from the government.
Holy smokes, isn't that something? That's a juicy little detail, David. Oh, that's a good pickup by you. Very well done. Okay, we've also been talking about this idea They're going to pursue this in the United States. Trump appointing Elon Musk, Vivek Ramaswamy to lead something called the Department of Government Efficiency, DOGE. There have been some suggestions in some circles that Canada should have a DOGE, Department of Government Efficiency, led by some successful entrepreneur. 1-833-668-2577. Keith calling from Ottawa. Keith.
This is so much bribery. It's incredible. What's the definition of essential service? Our groceries now we don't pay any GST on, correct?
Correct. Unless it's prepared in advance, right?
Yes, so, unless it's prepared in advance. So I wouldn't know if that's necessarily essential. Going out to a restaurant, is that essential? My point is, this is going to hurt children, the way I see it, of the lower marginalized people, in that the person's not going to save any money on buying groceries, but they're going to save money on buying beer and wine and some of these cocktail mixtures. So I can see a guy, you know, family, $100, coming home and saying, well, I think I'll buy some extra beer this week because I don't have to pay the GST on it, and that's going to take away from the grocery budget. I can see that happening. Can you imagine all the people that were so smart they shopped early this year for the clothes for the grandkids?
I'm just wondering
if a lot of people will be taking these items back.
Well, you know, that's been raised already, Keith, by the Canadian Federation of Independent Businesses. It says they're already getting emails from concerned members of the CFIB who are saying, we've sold all this stuff in advance. We've had Christmas sales and Black Friday sales and everything going on. And they fear people are going to do returns. And they're going to come back on the 14th or 15th of December and buy the exact same items just to save the GST.
And ones that are returned may have to be sold at a reduced price. So they're going to get squeezed. And as far as having this special committee, I thought the Auditor General was supposed to be doing all this stuff. What I think we should do is maybe have a committee like this, but have some kind of rotating people from the business world. One of your previous callers said a college professor, for God's sakes, no. Somebody from the business world to come in and look how government can be run more efficiently. Maybe inclusive with the Auditor General. I don't know about setting up a special committee, but some kind of sub-department there. But as I say, I think the Auditor General is supposed to be, and he does report on the efficiency of the government, right?
Okay. Yes, you're right. Yeah. Thank you, Keith, for sharing your thoughts. First-time caller out of Calgary is Tara. Thank you for calling, Tara. What's your opinion here, Tara?
I'm not really sure it's an opinion. It's more of a question in regards to the $250 check here. When we're saying that it's for people who worked, what does that exactly mean? I retired halfway through 2023, and I've opted not to work in another job. So does one need to be full-time? Is it part-time? Is it retirees? No, is it everybody?
David might have more details because he has the background material from the Department of Finance. Did you get a T4?
Yes.
Then you probably qualify, I would suspect. I mean, you'd have to be pretty unique not to qualify because it's 18.7 million people qualify for it.
yeah, exactly. Yeah. Right. So I just was listening and was thinking, okay, when we're talking about people who are working, what exactly? Because sometimes, well, you know, it's got to be full-time work. You got to have X number of hours or whatever, right?
Yeah, doesn't say that as far as I know. It's just as long as you worked in 2023.
Okay. And as for the GST vacation, again, really not a huge opinion, but I'm just curious as to how many people are going to compare the Black Friday sales to GST and make a decision as to whether they're going to purchase now or if they're going to wait.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
Let me ask you a question. Okay. Because it's just a funny side note that I have to this. Okay. When do you put your Christmas tree up?
Usually around December 10th.
Around December 10th. I just find this curious because they're taking the GST off of trees, Christmas trees, artificial and natural Christmas trees.
And I have an artificial that I've had for years, so I wouldn't be getting a tree anyways. So that particular item does not affect me.
Does not apply to you. Okay. All right. Thank you, Tara. All right. Good to hear from
Thanks
you.
So
yeah, bye-bye.
Have something on your mind you want everyone to know?
Call now.
Hello.
1-833-668-2577.
It's Talk Back on Now You Know with Rob Snow.
Been talking about the GST holiday, a $250 check coming your way, a Department of Government efficiency. Let's go to Grant. Grant is in Kitchener. You're a very patient man today. Grant, thank you. I wanted to get some new callers on there. Appreciate you calling, though.
That's fine and dandy. Yeah, I'm on a fixed income. I'll take the $250, but why not beginning of December? Why? I tried to sign up for a Christmas hamper here in Kitchener, and I was late in doing it, and it was filled up. They signed up 300 people last year. This year they signed up about 1,000.
Wow.
And I've been repetitively phoning the Liberal head office about them saying that, you know what, I want a food hamper. I qualify for it, and no one calls back, but I finally got in touch with one of the colleagues, and I mentioned to him, the Liberals are the responsible for the high food prices, and he would not budge, and he hung up. And if he thinks I'm going to vote for him, even though he's giving me this money, no, it's the same way with that segment that you had, I think, where someone where they were at Tim Hortons, and at the end of the line, they gave people.
Oh yeah, yes, that's right. Yeah. So, giving out the gift cards at the Tim Hortons, right, Grant?
Yeah, I'll take the gift card, but that doesn't mean I'm going to vote for you.
No, but I think this is an interesting point that you raise. If people are really in need, and this is, you know, the time of year when budgets are really stretched thin, you want to make sure there's something under the tree for your kids or whatever. Yeah, why not get the $250 into the bank account before Christmas? Part of the problem is that, first of all, they have to pass legislation through the House of Commons. So that's going to take some time. Okay, they've got to come up with that. But it is a good point you raise. I mean, I guess if I was, you know, being the skeptic that I usually am, in the spring we'll be that much closer to the election. And you'll remember getting that check closer to the election, I think. I think that may be part of the motivation. That's just me, though, and you know the way I am, Grant. So, right? But you raise some interesting points, Grant. Yeah, thank you.
Have something on your mind you want everyone to know?
Call now.
Hello.
1-833-668-2577.
It's Talk Back on Now You Know with Rob Snow.
Well, there's certainly a lot of interest today in this announcement from Justin Trudeau and Chrystia Freeland, the plan to cut the GST from a list of items in advance of Christmas. Let me run them down for you again. Children's clothing, footwear, diapers, car seats, select toys for kids under the age of 14, puzzles, video games, print newspapers and printed books, why is beyond me, natural and artificial Christmas trees, chips, candies, baked goods, all prepared meals and catered meals, pop bottled water, beer and wine, ciders and coolers with no more than 7% alcohol content. Not yet, not for wine, of course, but for the prepared cocktails. So that comes into effect on the 14th of December, lasts until the 15th of February. That's the plan right now. And then in the spring, late winter, early spring, a check is yours for $250. If you worked in 2023 and your income was no more than $150,000 net income, in other words, after tax, my goodness gracious, that is very generous of Mr. Trudeau. Janice. Hi, Janice. What do you think of all of this?
Hello?
Yes, Janice, go ahead.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Janice.
I was just wondering about the GOGE.
Department of Government Efficiency.
Yes, but what's the difference between that and quality control that they used to have on?
Okay. I don't really know what the difference between that and government and quality control would be. I guess if the goal in the United, Donald Trump thinks the government is too big, wastes too much money, and he wants to take a chainsaw to it. So he has these two very successful entrepreneurs. They're going to come in and they say they're going to slash hundreds of thousands of jobs, maybe even millions of jobs, closing entire departments down and tear up a bunch of regulations. That's what they want to do. What do you think of that?
I couldn't tell you.
No, okay.
I think it'll work. Right. Sometimes I think they should throw all the government and start all over again.
Yeah, well, okay. Well, I mean, this is probably the closest that they're ever going to get to it, I think, with those two in charge. Thank you, Janice. Let's go to Craig in Calgary. Thank you, Craig, for calling. We don't have a lot of time, maybe about a minute and a half or so. Go ahead, Craig.
Okay, so I think that this little gift that we're getting is a Band-Aid on a gaping wound. I think that it's we're coming up to an election, and here's a little bit of candy to maybe sway you, which I think is a joke. As far as the Doge is concerned, I think, yes, that is very, because the government has no transparency. They lie to you constantly, and there's no watchdog to oversee and keep the governments on track and honest. But I'd like to go further than that. I would like to see an elected Senate, because all of these politicians, well, the prime minister primarily, he is giving, loading up the Senate to sway to his way of thinking. And I think an elected Senate would also help as well as a Doge. I don't know if that's my thought.
Okay. Yeah, we've already kind of been down that road, and the Supreme Court has, it wasn't, I don't know if you could really call it a ruling, but more of guidance on even the possibility of having an elected Senate. This is all but impossible. Okay, that's about all the time we have for today. Thank you so much for all of your calls. Very busy. I'm glad you're taking note of what is happening in the country right now and paying attention to the current events of the day. Lots of new voices that I hope we get to know each other over the coming months, and you call back. Tomorrow we do the Friday free-for-all. Always a lot of fun. We've been coming up with topics all week. We don't do that on Fridays. We take our cue from you. You come up with a topic and we'll do our best to roll with it. That's how we roll on Friday. So join us then. It's a very busy news day. Lots to tell you about. Get you caught up at the top of the hour with the latest breaking news here on News Radio.